Previously on Advancements in Healthcare, we learned about Paul's struggle with shoulder pain and his decision to receive a shoulder replacement. Now, we'll see how the team comes together to ensure a successful operation in an outpatient environment.
The team is centered around the patient. I'm part of the team. The surgical team that's in the OR will be part of it, but we're all there for the patient, and I want them to have the trust and the faith that we're all working on behalf of their successful result.
Did you get some sleep last night?
Yeah,
sort of?
Yeah, a little bit. Nothing too crazy or less than normal.
Are there any questions that I can answer for you?
I think offhand, we've covered most of it. Yeah. Pretty much just letting you do your thing after this.
On the day of surgery, there's another opportunity for us to talk with the patient before surgery and their family. So as each step goes, it's very predictable, and it feels very comfortable that this is the way that the process should go in a successful environment.
I guess I feel ready to roll because the aftermath is the positive part, right? You're in great hands, professionals taking care of everything, and just sit down and go for the ride, so to speak.
Later on, when they're meeting with you, we'll check back and make sure everything's okay.
Okay.
All right?
Sounds good.
I'll see you in a little bit.
How'd you get squeamish around needles? No, you're good.
While Paul was prepped for surgery, Dr. Romeo gave the final review of the 3D images used to plan the operation. The program utilizes the CT scans to create a digital model that allows the team to install the implant with pinpoint accuracy.
This virtual implant positioning that we use allows us to plan out the operation very carefully. This is the CT scan rendition of his scapula. The advantage of this program is that we can then look at it at many different angles to make sure that that is put exactly in the right spot. So this really gives us tremendous ability to be very precise and accurate, all of which has benefits for the patient, not only in the short term, but the long term.
With a detailed plan in place and the patient prepped, it was time for surgery. The shoulder replacement was expected to take less than 2 hours.
Total shoulder replacements done in the hands of people that have really learned their skills is a very safe, reliable operation with a predictable outcome. The concept is the time of surgery is the time to do the operation, not to think about it. This runs like a well-oiled machine, like a pit crew at a NASCAR race. We've practiced this, we've done this over and over again, and because of that, we're able to do these operations in a very short period of time. That's one of the things that facilitates these procedures being done in the outpatient surgery center. Patients are under a very brief amount of anesthesia. The blood loss is relatively minimal, less than you would lose if you were donating blood for the Red Cross. And everybody makes sure that the operation goes step by step until it's completed. And that's it. This is the final screen for the room. We're all set.
After a successful surgery, Dr. Romeo's team checks Paul out, and he's free to begin his recovery from the comfort of his own home.
We make sure that he is awake, we make sure that he's not feeling too much nausea, and that he's able to hold down a little fluid and food. We're able to let him go home on the same day as the surgery.
Everything went great. The tendon that we go through to do the surgery and repair back down looked very healthy. So I have no concerns about that whatsoever.
I feel fine, you know, once some of the anesthetic wore off to a little bit of the nausea, but my shoulder doesn't hurt. This isn't really that uncomfortable because I mean, I kind of knew it was going to be sitting in a position, but no, I mean, like I said, it feels great.
So. Yeah, good.
Good news. Take care. Best of luck to you.
On the next installment of Advancements in Healthcare, Paul navigates the road to recovery that will lead to a successful rehabilitation.
If you have questions about shoulder replacement surgery or rotator cuff surgery, please give us a call or contact us online. There are treatment options available that can get you back to the things that you would love to do.